Roadhard Roadhouse is sponsored by Speedy's Industrial Coatings in Ozark, Missouri. They do powder coating, media blasting, big or small, they do it all. Tell them the Roadhard Roadhouse sent you. So, the Roadhard Roadhouse, we're going to paint this 454 Chevy Orange from Eastwood. So, let's get this thing started. Let's get this thing looking pretty. As far as the engine paint goes, I ordered them both from Eastwood, but they came from different areas. So, but they came in the same dang box. So, let's see what we got here. Looks like it's packed very well. This is the activator for the paint, so I'm hoping that this is my paint. It came pretty well packed too. This is my 1 quart Chevy Orange high temperature ceramic engine paint from Eastwood. This is what's going to go on my motor, my 454 for the 396 Super Sport Nova. Pretty excited about this today. I think it's 4-1. Yep, 4-1. Four parts, one part. Good deal. We're going to turn this primered motor into this. Four parts paint to one part activator. All right. This is the color that I wanted, so I'm good. This is Eastwood. I wanted to go pour 15. If you've watched a lot of my videos, I am a pour 15 guy. But they were saying that the color wasn't exact. And I didn't want it if it wasn't the color. This is pretty bright. I expect to have to put at least 2 coats of this on. Now, I was reading the reviews, and some people were saying it's kind of thin. I don't think so. If I don't like this going on with the brush, I will put it on with the paint gun. I like this Chevy Orange. Now I am gonna go to Ha Ha Tonka today. It's a state park. So I do not need to hurry. I'm gonna put one coat on here and then leave. And then come back tonight or tomorrow morning and put the second coat on. I am not in any hurry. Now, you could probably put this stuff on. It's dripping a little bit. Probably put this stuff on without the activator, but they recommend the activator. Because the activator, it seems like it's a little bit thinner than 415. I am dripping here. Definitely, from right now, it looks like it's going to need a second coat for sure. The activator is supposed to help it not chip. It's going to help it not chip. So that's why I got it. I don't want to do this. I'm sure you all don't want to do this very many times. I'm going to put just a tad bit more paint just to see if it'll thicken it up a little bit. Like pour 15, because pour 15 would self-level. not sure if I told you all this, but the pour, this paint is $60 with the activator. It's $40, something like that, around that price. $40, and then you have to buy the activator. You don't have to, I'm sorry. This shit is running. Tell you the truth, I did not think that it would run like this. I mean, I read where people had complained about it running, but I saw where people complained where they thought they were going to need like four coats. I don't think that this is going to need four coats, but it sure as heck looks like it's going to need two. I don't know if my camera is going to show. This is really bright. Awesome looking color. It's on a Chevrolet 454. This paint is supposed to be good for 650 degrees. I think it's the highest one on the market right now, that I know of anyway. Said, if I don't like how this comes out by brushing it on, I will spray it on with paint. Got all the holes blocked off with fabric or tape. If I had an engine stand, this might be a little bit easier because I could just, you know, rotate the motor. Because underneath here, it is dripping even more. Might ask why I wanted to go with this expensive stuff. I wanted to go with it just to try it out, mainly for y'all. And I don't want to have to do this again. If it was up to me and I wasn't doing videos, I would probably just buy the best spray paint out there. But I want y'all to know how this stuff works. I want you to all know the easy way, which is by painting with a brush. Now, like I told you before, I have a lot of more experience dealing with the POR 15 products, POR 15, whatever you guys want to call it. Okay, it may look great, but it was a pain in the ass. I'm going to come back later today. When I get back tonight or tomorrow, and I am going to paint it with a paint gun. This brushing on, it was a little thin. So unless you've got your motor on an engine stand where you can rotate it, it was a pain. I got it everywhere. Wow. I don't like to cuss in my videos, but I'm pretty ticked off about this. I've used POR 15 pretty much for the last almost 17 years, maybe a little longer, and this is unacceptable. It says that it self-levels. I don't agree, but don't get me wrong, it looks really great from about 2.5-3 feet away. I am gonna spray it and I may still like it, so the verdict is not in yet. Okay, what I can say about putting this on with a brush, don't do it at all. It wasn't worth it. Get a spray gun, spray it. Get the activator, four parts paint, one part activator, and that will come out 100,000 times better than with a brush. The brush, as you can tell in some of the video that I took, that it didn't do very well. As far as Pour 15 versus EASTWOOD, Pour 15 is a self-leveler. It takes care of all that stuff. EASTWOOD, I have read that it does the same thing. I would not agree with that whatsoever at all. But of course, this is my experience, not everybody's experience. If you're looking for something that you want to put on with a brush, go Pour 15. This right here, it looks great, but I brushed it the first one and then I came back around and did it. I sprayed it the second time. I couldn't stand how it came out the first time. It's gonna need two coats anyway, if you brush it on. So I went ahead and sprayed it. I did not need a third coat. I thought I was going to, I did not. But the second coat I did spray it, and I went around and made sure there was enough coating everywhere. This looks great. The first coat, like I said, it did not self-level, so there was a few spots that looked where you can feel that there's ridges in it. And it was mainly on my right... I can't do it. It was mainly on my valve covers, and those valve covers are coming off anyway to put chrome ones on. So at least I escaped any damage on that. But everything else looks great. I've got enough left to do probably maybe two more engines. And I've got a motor for the 5.3, or I got a motor for the Jeep, the 5.3. That's gonna go in that one. And love to put this Chevy orange on it. As far as, then I got a 67 Impala that it's gonna need to get painted as well. So I'll waste this on that stuff, and I won't have any left. But thank you all for watching, liking, subscribing. Comment down below, tell me what experiences you've had with EASTWOOD paint. This is not too bad of stuff. I'll give you the number right here. It is EASTWOOD Chevy Orange 51618. Z is in Zulu, P is in Papa. All right, appreciate it, and everybody have a good night. And as always, if you ride her hard, don't put her way wet.